Get ready for the dictation. Dictation will start in 5 seconds. Start. Sir, the mounting, galloping public expenditure, mainly financed not out of real resources but out of public debts or borrowings, creates an internal debt trap, and that can be only matched or met by seeing that whatever money is spent productively, and all the money that is not being spent productively is cut out. There is control on expenditure. I think this mechanism will be much more effective when put in operation, and it could control the deficit that the country has experienced. Now, sir, the objective and philosophy of the plan, squarely put as the Nehruvian model of growth with social justice based on modernization. Our economy has progressed on these lines, and the entire industrial sector is in the midst of a new industrial revolution. This new industrial revolution, formulated by the ideas of the Prime Minister, is that there should be increased productivity and efficiency. It also reflects the modern management technique. All these are the qualitative aspects of the new industrial revolution that is ushered into the country as the second industrial revolution. First industrial revolution was ushered in by Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru when the second plan was introduced, whose main goals were public sector, building up capital good, agricultural production, and self-reliance of the country. The country has progressed in this direction, and India is now one of the most industrialized economies, but there are large gaps, and Prime Minister has introduced the second phase of the industrial revolution with its emphasis on modernization, efficiency, and productivity. This applies not only to public sector, but it also applies to the new technologies that are being used in the agricultural sector. The breakthrough in agricultural production is concentrated only in certain regions, while there is great resurgence in certain areas of the country, their areas have difficulties. Only a certain class of people are benefiting because of the agricultural development. Water management, technological management, and other inputs used in agriculture are costly, and the result is that the cost of production in agriculture is as costly as the industrial production. Therefore, by introducing the new management revolution in agriculture and industry, there will be more and more emphasis on modernization, efficiency, and getting the best results out of the investment. And I only like to point out that it must be made much more broad-based in the sphere of agriculture. Full stop.